Oh, Estelle, you look so cute.
Really? I'm glad. I was worried these clothes wouldn't look good on me. They seem kind of old-fashioned. That's what makes them cute. I wasn't talking about myself.
No, it's okay.
I was just saying that the clothes are cute, not me.
You don't need to be so modest. You're so cute.
Than you usually do. You look cute.
Are you saying I normally don't look cute?
No, that's not what I meant.
Well, it's not like I care anyway.
Hey, Yuri, you think she looks cute, right? Don't you?
Huh? Yeah. I like those cat ears, I guess.
Just the ears?
Oh, come on, Yuri. Why are you being so shy? Your face is turning red.
The ears are the problem.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, it's cold, cold, cold. So cold, 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 cold.
So, what are you gonna do with the air crane?
I'm gonna use the energy to make an air converter.
An air converter?
My plan is to efficiently convert the air into matter, decreasing the overall amount of air. But for that, it's ideal to have the converter use energy similar to both air and matter.
How is that energy different from air?
Elementally separated air transitions into matter in stages and eventually becomes stable. I'm going to stop its transition between the two states and develop a converter formula.
So it won't be air or matter?
It's a state that's closer to matter than to air, but it's still not quite matter. We call it mana.
Mana. To think that one short utterance could hold more gravity than the light used to lure fish out of the frigid sea at night.
It actually has a really long, complicated name, but mana's good enough. But it'll still be less stable than actual matter, so we'll need something to act as a core.
The Epithea.
And a lot of air and Estelle's power to recombine the formula.
Using my power without the control formula will unbalance the air. It'll just flood out again.
But we can't just sit here and ignore that thing. And...
Yeah?
It's a bet I'm willing to take.
I guess I should be the one trying to stop you, but I'm game to get in on this bet, too.
I'll wager $1 billion on that.
The theory is correct. It'll be okay.
I'll return this $1 billion to you many times over.
Oh, truly now?
Yep. Come on, let's head to the Air Creme.
Huh? Are you catching a cold, Estelle?
No, it's just... I've been so cold ever since I saw Rita use that water magic of hers.
That's terrible! Are you sure you're okay?
No, it's both of you. You should just tell Rita to stop using that kind of magic.
I can hear Rita already. I'll decide what type of magic I use, thank you very much.
Oh, come on. If we tell her that we might be coming down with colds, I'm sure she'll...
What's that? Something about me?
Hey, you catch a cold too?
Maybe someone's talking about me behind my back.
That's Rita for you.
I tell you, thinking of a converter for air. You're quite the thinker. That's our genius mage girl, Rita. Yep.
Well, I had a hint to go off of.
Come to think of it, you did say you'd investigated Zod, didn't you?
Despite its amazing size, it wasn't running off of air, even though it was a barrier blastia to protect the entire world.
A barrier blastia? Oh yeah, they were protecting the world from the Autophagos.
You mean to say it's been there for a millennium? It's as dogged as a philosophizing anemone!
Same goes for the Autophagos. It's been clinging to that barrier for just as long.
Alexei seemed to believe Zod was a weapon, but he couldn't have been more mistaken.
But the runaway air was the cause for the Autophagos' awakening, wasn't it? Ah, so that's why they would use a barrier running on power other than air.
But then, what sort of power was it using?
The Children of the Full Moon, perhaps?
It was actually energy taken straight from them. Inside that giant core, it continued to power Zod as a virtually perpetual formula. Most likely, the energy was taken in exchange for their lives.
The light of life was extinguished from the Children of the Full Moon.
So that's what Miorso's legend meant.
According to Duke, they did it of their own free will. They wanted to save the world.
The love the Children of the Full Moon bore for this world is what created the barrier.
The power of love. Makes you want to cry.
They sacrificed themselves for the world. The Children of the Full Moon were protecting us the entire time.
Sorry, but you're going bye-bye. Well, what do you think?
Whoa!
And just what are you staring at?
I was just thinking that if Judith was a waitress somewhere, I'd go there every single day!
Ah, Carol. Taken by the charms of an older woman. Of course, I'd do the same thing.
Thanks, guys. I wonder if I should show a little more. You know.
Oh, yes! Oh, God, yes!
Judith, I think that's enough. I can't stand seeing Raven like this for much longer.
Wishes.
monster's not going to show up again, right?
If it does, you'll beat it up for us just like the last time, right?
You're mean.
Okay, I'm ready. Estelle, come over here. Now, I'll release the control formula. Once I do that, the air crene will react to you and produce more air. I want you to recompose the air formula into a stable formula closer to mana.
I don't understand.
Yeah. Okay, the water element is strong here, so imagine flowing water and let your body flow with the air. The theory behind materializing air is the same as performing magic. If Estelle can recompose the air into a state close to mana, then I should be able to guide the air into the Cyanociel.
Can we do anything?
No. Go take a nap or something.
We'd freeze to death if we took a nap here.
We're pretty handy, you know. We can cook or fish or anything you want. Just tell us what to do.
I wouldn't say anything.
We can use the conversion formula we found in Zaude.
That was for substituting life for air. Your life! You can't do that!
But if this fails, then we'll all be swallowed up by a flood of air. We'll be dead anyway, right?
We're all risking our lives. Let us help.
All right. I'll use your life energy to guide the air into the Cyanociel. If we do that, I think Estelle will understand the flow of the air without interference from me.
All right, everyone. Let's do this.
Sure. Okay.
Why not?
Ready, Estelle? Here we go. Everyone, come over here. Go ahead. Try and synchronize yourself with my formula. There, that's good. In the Cyanociel. The formula's working. The force field is stable. It's gonna be okay.
What happened?
Did it not work?
No, it's still under control, but what is this? Formula for reshaping the apatheia. It's reformulating itself.
I am
that voice. Bellius?
Judith? Yes, it is I, Bellius. Or rather, I was once Bellius, but no more.
What's going on here?
Could the will of Bellius trapped in the apatheia have... Amazing!
I feel the waters of the world at my command. I am the ruler of the waters.
Okay, so... Did it work?
It's gone way beyond working. I never thought it would gain a will of its own.
nature's mysteries will forever transcend the limited scope of our imagination.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you on this one.
Humans? What creature am I? Though no longer Belius the Intellikeia, you have granted life to me. I ask that you give me a name.
A being that controls the essence of a material. Maybe you're a spirit.
And so my name shall be...
the Splishy Splashy Watercolor Queen!
An ancient word for the ruler of the waters. How about Undine?
Undine. Henceforth, I shall be known as the Spirit Undine. Ah, I feel the power swell within me. Such is the benefit of the air which you saw fit to gather for me.
It wasn't any cakewalk either.
Receive this now as token of my thanks.
Undini, we need to get the world's air under control. Please, lend us your power.
Very well. However, my powers alone will be insufficient.
Huh?
I control only the waters. You must gather those who rule the other elements as well.
The elements of earth, water, wind, and fire. We need at least three more.
We'll need help from the other Intellikeia, won't we?
Aye. There are very few Intellikeia left. Pharaoh, Gusios.
And Ba'ul.
Not Ba'ul. He hasn't taken in enough air to create an apatheia. And on top of that, I won't allow it.
Undine, do you have any ideas?
The shining forest of Arialumum and Reliwese, the root of the world. Your friend Ba'ul should know the location of these places.
She disappeared!
No, she is here. I feel her.
It seems like the air crina has quieted down too, even though we're not controlling Estelle's power.
Really? So, Undine is controlling Estelle's power?
You mean Estelle is really free?
Yes. Yes!
That's great, Estelle.
Well, things are sure taking a turn for the strange.
Yeah, I never would have dreamed any of this would happen. But we finally see the light at the end.
It's a pinprick, but as welcome as the rays of sun that pierce into the ocean's depths.
Rita, you look happy.
So do you, Yuri.
There's no longer anything shackling Estelle. She can use her power without causing any harm to herself or unbalancing the air. So yeah, I'm happy.
Estelle's really free!
There's no guarantee she won't overdo things again, though.
We'll just watch her closely. If we don't, she might go back to healing people till she keels over.
You picked the wrong people to fight with.
Is Undine really here?
Yes. I can't really explain it, but she is here. I can sense it.
Perhaps she dwells within Estelle.
Well, she was created through Estelle, so maybe the two are connected. Very interesting.
Hey, save the research for later, okay?
I know. You don't have to...
just now!
Isn't that where?
It came from the direction of Zaude.
No. Has Zaude stopped working?
Uh-oh. Do you think we might have done something to set this off?
That is the true catastrophe.
That thing does look like it could eat the whole world.
What are we supposed to do about something like that?
It's a touch too big to fillet with just my kitchen knife.
Hey, Rita. Duke said the Autophagos was born from air.
Huh?
So if the spirits convert air into matter, could we do something about the Autophagos if we had enough spirits?
I don't know. I don't know. But I do think it's worth a try.
Let's try it, Yuri.
Then it's settled.
Baul!
Yes, I see. Thank you. The servants of the Autophagos are attacking the city, Nordopolica.
I guess we can't ignore something like that. Let's go.
I'm gonna hurt that idiot who brought the Autophagos back.
What could have happened at Zaude?
Those nutjobs probably fiddled with the thing too much and broke it.
Thanks to Alexei, Zaude's no longer functioning like it was meant to.
Greed always eats itself. That wouldn't be a problem if there weren't other victims.
This guy just never learns, does he? Things are gonna have to hit bottom before he consider changing his ways.
But they see that thing about to eat the planet, right? Even an idiot would understand the situation.
I sure hope so.
That's what we saw on the sands of Kogor.
That was Pharaoh's vision. This is real. Be careful.
It looks like it's trying to eat the air of the shield.
Is the Autophagos drawn to air?
This thing looks pretty mean.
It may be, but it's what we've caught on our line. We'll reel it right in.
Come on.
Luna cry!
right, let's go check it out.
Hurry!
I'm even stronger now.
Hold your position. We're gonna stop them here.
Things getting wild around here.
You were... I guess I'm saved again.
It seems that this was the only city to be attacked. What bad luck.
This isn't about luck.
Where were you, Rita?
I went to check the barrier Blastia. Its power had been raised, and I guess the monsters were drawn to it. The power is returned to normal now.
We thought raising the power would protect us, but it turned out to be the opposite. I'll go see the citizens. Feel free to rest here as long as you please.
Thanks for the offer, but we still have business to do. We better get moving.
You are all welcome at any time. Try stopping by when you have the time.
Thanks.
Ew! I can't believe the Autophagos could spawn such a disgusting monster!
The illusion Pharaoh showed us. He was trying to make us feel the power of the Autophagos.
But it's no illusion this time. Oh man, are hordes of these things just gonna attack everything?
Ow! Hey, no biting!
It's all right, Rapide. He's just a little nervous, that's all.
And what's wrong with being a little nervous? I'm not gonna run away or anything, I swear! Was really working hard.
Yeah, it looks like he's doing a good job leading since Belly has passed away.
I'd like him to meet Undine. He'd be so happy.
Not right now. Once everything's settled down, though, let's give him a nice surprise.
Okay.
That monster. Paul Astrale was no match for it. I can't figure it out.
So how did we take it out?
Maybe there's something different about us.
The spirits, perhaps? If the Autophagos really is close to air, then the spirits might actually affect it.
So can we put up more of a fight if we get the other three?
Who knows? The four elements alone could control air, but we're talking about the Autophagos. I just don't know.
Yeah, and it's not like you can find Apatheia lying around just anywhere.
There aren't many Entelechea left either.
Hey, there are tons of Blastia all over the world, right?
Yes. They're an indispensable part of our society.
And cores are just pieces of Apatheia. So if the four spirits aren't enough, we can just change all the cores of the world into spirits too, right?
Then we may end up with as many spirits as there are grains of sand.
Are you nuts? How do you propose to do that?
Even if we knew how, we'd still have to go to every single Blastia. I doubt the Autophagos would wait for us.
I think that's your specialty, genius.
Oh no! This is your genius plan.
Even if Yuri's plan worked, all the Blastia would stop working, wouldn't they?
Yeah, I guess so. All the cores would be gone.
What would the world become?
People would lose the safety promised by the barriers.
All the functions that the Blastia maintained, gone. It'll be inconvenient, to say the least.
Even Bodhi Blastia wouldn't work.
Who cares? Blastia or no Blastia, a single oar is all I need to cross the ocean.
I admire your spirit, Patty.
Well, isn't that all fine and dandy?
There'll be a lot of unhappy people, but we have to do it.
Otherwise, the world will fall to the Autophagos, even if no one else ever understands why.
Well, for now, let's just get the four elemental spirits.
Aye. We'll cross those other bridges when we come to them.
Baul knows where the other Entelekea are, right?
Yeah. Let's get back to the ship and ask him.
The shining forest of Aeria Lumen, and the root of the world, Reluise.
I've never heard of those places.
If only we could glimpse them.
It would make things far easier.
Baul says he knows. However, he doesn't want to tell us. Apatheia's only come from the death of Entelekea.
He doesn't want to put his friends in danger.
Baul, listen. We want to protect the world, but we don't want to sacrifice anyone for it. We won't just take the Apatheia by force.
Baul, please.
Tell us where the Entelekea are.
Aeria Lumen is in the northeast part of Tolbikia. Reluise is on the continent of Wakea.
Thank you, Baul.
We also need to go to the Sands of Kogor, where Pharaoh is.
Right.
Northeast Tolbikia. I wonder if that's the place where a new land just recently crystallized.
Wakea is that continent to the south of Ilikia, where the capital is, right?
Wakea? The Emperor Kalx III sent scouting parties 4 times in order to claim the land, but every time they lost communication and no one ever returned. It's the last unexplored land on Terkalumeres.
Why does it have to be a place like that?
If Wakea is that bad, then let's leave Reluise for last.
He says he'll leave things up to you.
Thanks, Baul. Let's go.
We can't exactly dawdle forever.
did things have to end up the way they did?
At this point, there's no use mulling over whether we chose the right course or not.
But we need to think about it so the same thing doesn't happen again.
It's becoming harder and harder to make a legitimate living in this world. I'm not saying this should excuse what I've done.
You can't go through your entire life doing what's right. It's sad, but that's reality.
But that doesn't mean someone who used their sword for justice will just turn evil for no reason. As long as they were fighting to protect someone right and good.
But accept that, and things break down to anarchy.
I want to change the world so those who are just can lead good lives. A world where we can't have justice without making someone else the bad guy is just too sad.
It'd be nice if people could just talk things over.
Yeah, that'd be a nice start.
That's why I'm saying that you shouldn't carry this burden by yourself.
So what's Bowel saying?
It seems that even he can tell he's bursting with power.
Awesome! Even Entelechea grow up, huh?
Bowel's still very young, so he probably has a lot of growing left in him.
So young and already this big? Old Raven sure is jealous.
I think it'd be better if you grew up in a different way, old man.
Huh?
A book in the warehouse said this city rose into the air at the end of the Goryeo civilization.
So that would mean it was on land before that happened?
That part wasn't clear, but I think the city was probably floating on the ocean until then.
Oh, so that's why it got eaten by a giant jellyfish.
I don't think that's quite what happened.
Thank you.